I bought a Wii U in 2023. Why? The exclusives, I tell you! The Wii U was extremely unique since it was the only home console to use two screens. There were a bunch of clever ideas of how to use the second screen to the player's advantage. But I know what you might be thinking. But Steven, a lot of the Wii U games were ported over to the Nintendo Switch. Well, to you, my friend, I say, not all of them. Not all of them that matter to me. I'm thinking of Nintendo Land, Splatoon, Rayman Legends, not an exclusive, but had a great gamepad integration, The Legend of Zelda Wind Waker HD and Twilight Princess HD, and more. There is no way that Nintendo Land will ever get a port to the Nintendo Switch. Nintendo could make a sequel, but the experiences delivered on the Wii U are fantastic. The original Splatoon was the beginning of a new series that I have loved ever since the first release on the Wii U system. And not to mention the final boss on the Wii U on the first game was absolutely incredible, and I was laughing hysterically the whole time. It was fantastic. Rayman Legends is not the same on any other platform. The way that Ubisoft used the gamepad to their advantage was absolutely brilliant. Especially those running levels where you had to like open up all the walls and stuff and move all the obstacles out of the way when you're being chased by a dragon. Oh, so good. So good. I am also aware of the rumors that Wind Waker HD and Twilight Princess HD are coming to the Nintendo Switch. Maybe. Take that with a big grain of salt, because haven't come yet. But they won't be able to use the dual screen functionality that I loved so much while playing both of those games. The way you can have your map open at all times and be able to swap out any item at any time was so great. And the number one reason, here we go, number one reason. Let me introduce you to a game I've been dying to play since I sold my Wii U. A game I thought Nintendo would for sure port over. Yoshi's Woolly World. Yoshi's Woolly World is my favorite Yoshi game of all time. The art style makes the yarn look real. The characters and environment are absolutely adorable. I love the way Yoshi's feet turn into a helicopter while hovering, and wheels while running, and all those small little details that just make the game so distinct and so good. The level design is out of this world, and especially good if you're a completionist. And they are all insanely creative. The way they hide the collectibles is absolutely brilliant, and it's so good, so good. So, oh man, I just love it so much. And the music, don't even get me started. The music absolutely sets the atmosphere for each level, and sets the adorable level to like an 11. It's one of the best soundtracks Nintendo has ever done. I was crushed when the port of Yoshi's Woolly World went to the Nintendo 3DS on February 2nd, 2017, instead of the newly announced Nintendo Switch. And I've been crushed ever since that Poochie and Yoshi's Woolly World still has not seen a port to the Nintendo Switch. Another reason I bought a Wii U in 2023 is because of the virtual console functionality. So I know we have the Nintendo Switch Online service, and they're bringing over a lot of those games to that service, but they don't have everything right now, and it's hard to get your hands on some of these great classics that you want to play. Well, on the Wii U, I have a whole library of games that I can play that I've purchased in the past, and now I have access to those again because I cannot access those on my Nintendo Switch. So that has been absolutely incredible, and not to mention, it's right now the only place I can play the Metroid Prime trilogy, because again, rumors of that have been going around for a long time, and we've seen nothing. There's been nothing. Hopefully that Metroid Prime rumor remake is real, because that'd be awesome. But for now, that is the only way I can play the Metroid Prime games, is on my Wii U. And now I have it again, and now I can play it again, thank goodness. And this is my, this might be an unfortunate thing to say and confess to, I have actually never beaten Metroid Prime 3. So, yeah. I need to repent. Anthony has been on my case about that for years. But now I can finally say I have access to it, and I can finally beat it before Metroid Prime 4 comes out. So yeah, that sounds absolutely great. Anyway, those are my reasons for getting a Wii U in 2023. Let me know down in the comments below if you think I'm crazy, or if you agree with me that there are some great exclusives on the Nintendo Wii U that will never see the light on another console because of the unique dual screen functionality. Because I think they had some really good things going on the Wii U, even though it was so barren and there was nothing to play ever at any point. There's very few and far between, maybe two games a year. It was so barren. But had they, you know, marketed this thing better, named it something else, got rid of all that confusion, I think this system actually would have done really well. And I wish it would have. But here we are, alas. However, if I had to, if it would have been successful, maybe we have never gotten the Nintendo Switch. And I have to say, sorry, Wii U, but the Nintendo Switch is my favorite Nintendo system of all time. However, the Wii U has a special place in my heart and will forever and ever. And I know it's just because I'm a big nerd. But anyway, let me know down in the comments below what you think of the Nintendo Wii U and about its marketing and the games. I'd love to hear it all, especially if you have any recommendations of what games I should play on the Wii U that I maybe haven't played yet. For example, I've never played Zombie U. It was a launch title for the system, never played it. Anyway, let me know down in the comments below what games I should play. And if you think I'm crazy, I'd love to know. And thank you so much for listening. And if you like this video, guys, please give us a like and a subscribe. It always helps us out. We're trying to get to 1,000 subscribers this year. So please, and if you have any feedback or anything else you'd like to see in our videos or future content, please let us know down in the comments what you'd like us to be working on. We'd love to know. And until next time, guys, keep it nerdy.